Hey guys, in this video I'll show you how to prevent PayPal from blocking your business. So let's say you're getting sales and maybe you have had this situation before. You're getting sales, you're scaling your store, you're basically, you know, growing your business, right? And then suddenly one day you're getting an email, right, that your PayPal account is blocked or restricted or you have some limitations on it. So you're running business, you're using PayPal platform, right? So from their perspective, they want to limit their risk, right? Let's say you're a business and you're collecting payments from people, right? Let's say you're collecting, you know, a lot of money for, you know, for the orders that you need to fulfill. And then suddenly you decide to, you know, not to fulfill those orders and just go for a vacation for a year, right? So that's a risk, right? And they want to limit that risk because, you know, otherwise, like if they don't limit that risk, they have to, chase you, they have to sue your business, they have to, you know, basically look for you, right? So typically what they will ask you for when this happens, right? It's either verifying your business and providing the information that will help them to verify that your business is legitimate, that you're sending orders, maybe some agreements from the suppliers that you have, right? The tracking numbers, right? So kind of like the proof of your business existence and registration number, tax IDs, those kind of things. Those kind of things will allow them to see that you're a real business, you're in, you know, in the business for a long time, and you will actually fulfill the order, so they'll not have any issues with you. So there are a few things that you need to do. Basically, for example, if this happens to you, you don't need to remove the PayPal from your store, right? That's typically the first reaction, because a lot of the customers might use PayPal to pay you, right? And at the same time, you know, you don't want to sacrifice that, so your conversion rate will drop if you remove the PayPal. And also it will send them like a bad signal, like to PayPal, that, you know, you're removing the PayPal from your website, whereas, you know, you're fighting with chargebacks and some of the disputes with your customers, right? So prepare the business information, invoice from the manufacturers, expected, you know, volume of orders, a number of employees, basically everything that you can collect that will make you look like a legitimate business, right? And they'll probably ask you to provide like lots of tracking numbers, right? Always make sure that you're only using ePacket, right? That you're using some like courier company that has the, you know, like accurate tracking numbers, you know, so you need to, you work with like the right suppliers and you have like the full transparency. And to automate this process, basically to add like each order that you fulfill with PayPal, you need to have the tracking number for it, right? And to automate that process, we recently discovered the app called TrackyPay. So if you use like TrackyPay, you can basically upload the tracking numbers into your for each of the order that you fulfill, basically make it in a more like automated way. Let's say if you're making like 100 or like 1,000 orders per day, you can just automate this whole process using TrackyPay. Never remove, like, let's say if you have like, you know, $10,000 or $100,000 in your PayPal account, don't remove like all of the money, you know, at once, like in big bulks, right? Because, you know, from the PayPal perspective, like you're just extracting money from it, like, so you might be just deciding, you know, to close the business or not fulfill the orders. So again, don't send those signals to it, to PayPal. Just remove those money like in small parts, right? And always have some money on your PayPal account. So for them, it looks like, okay, so you're serious, like you're not, you know, you're not in a short time for business, and you basically, you know, in a business for real, to provide real value and send products to your customers. Generally, try to withdraw your money, but don't, you know, withdraw your money like in big bulks. Let's say if you have like $1,000 on it, like don't withdraw like 1,000 at the same time, or 100,000, don't withdraw like huge amount of money at the same time. So, and whenever the dispute comes to you, respond to it immediately. You know, so if you have someone disputing the order, just send all of the information. If you have the tracking number, if you have order confirmation, if you have like all of these like details, maybe communication with customers, tracking ID, right? So all of those things, just dispute, like answer to that dispute immediately. So this will basically put your account in a strong case, you know, with in a strong standing with PayPal that will allow you to use their platform for a long time. Because, you know, if you think about like millions of businesses using it, So it's a good platform. You just like you need to prove that you're a trustworthy business and you're good to deal with. So these are the tips, guys, that you need to use to basically not let PayPal block your dropshipping business and basically put you out of business. So these are the tips. Put them to work. Use TrackyPay. Upload shipping numbers. Just do as any legitimate business would do, and you will do very well. Thank you, guys. I'll see you in the next video. Please subscribe to my channel. Make sure that you like this video and put your comments below. If you want me to cover any other topics, let me know what you think in the comments. Thank you, guys.